Define phase is the most important phase of the DMAIC process. This is where you choose the project, determine what you'll accomplish in concrete terms. After you finish with defining the problem, you write objective statement that outlines the project scope, defines concrete and measurable goals, and provide a timeline for project. You will also identify all stakeholders and project team and create a plan for execution for next steps in the process. So let's jump in, and don't forget to hit the like and subscribe buttons not to miss future content. First phase of the DMAIC process is define. In this phase, you need to have the team and sponsor to reach agreement on the scope of the project, goals and financials, as well as performance targets for the project. Key deliverables are a completed project charter covering the business statement, business impact, goals, scope, timeline, and defined team. Documentations, what customers are or will be affected by this project and what are their needs. Customers can be internal or external. High-level process map, for example, SIPOC. Completed project plans. These plans include Gantt charts, stakeholder analysis, resistance analysis, risk analysis, action logs, responsibility assignments, and communication plans. And last, outcomes from the project launch meeting showing team consensus around project purpose, charter, deliverables, and team responsibilities. In order to successfully accomplish this phase of the project, I encourage you to follow 7 steps in defined phase. Some companies have whole team to do this work, and others have black belts to do some or all of the work before bringing the rest of the team to the table. You should do what fits your situation or your company. These are the 7 steps. First step, review project charter. In this step, review and discuss with your team draft charter from sponsors. Ask questions and get answers. Negotiate compromises or adjustments to scope, resources, timing, and who should be on your team. Second step, validate problem statement and goals. Review existing and other resources of information to confirm if the problem you are given exists, is important to your customer, is important to your business, can reasonably be expected to be improved using Lean Six Sigma methodologies. Third step, validate financial benefits. Use existing data to calculate current cost, profits, margins, or other financial metrics relevant to your project. Estimate impact of the project and verify if that is something that is meeting management expectations. Fourth step, create or validate process maps and scope. Here, you will want to document main steps of the process with SIPOC diagram to verify project scope, see if data exists to provide baseline measures on time, defects, errors, rework, and many others for value stream map. I have already mentioned SIPOC. In short, it is a snapshot that captures information critical to a project. It is abbreviation from suppliers, inputs, process, outputs, and customers. Best way is to start from capturing the process at high level, then output, inputs, and so on. Now going back to our 7 steps. Fifth step is create communication plan. Identify all project participants and develop plans for keeping them informed and or involved in the project. Sixth step is to develop project plans. This means schedule, budget, and realistic milestones. As a seventh step, you should complete Define checklist. So let's quickly go through the checklist for Define phase. These are four steps at the checklist. A. Updated project charter consisting of following: problem statement, detailing when did the problem occur, what is the problem, magnitude of the problem, and impact of problem. Focus only on symptoms, not solutions and causes. Key stakeholders, who are they? How will they be involved in the project? Business impact, goal statement, verification of project scope, high-level project plans, list of your team members. B. Documentation on your customer. You should identify primary external and internal customers. You should gather voice of customer. Customer needs to be evaluated for priority and importance. You should have the ability to measure customer requirements. C. SIPOC diagram. And D. Detailed project management plans. You should have more detailed schedule of activities, for example, by using Gantt chart. You should get list of stakeholders who will be impacted by the project and their expectations and concerns. Communication plan, risk management plans, identification of barriers or obstacles. So, there are several tips and tricks you should be aware of to perform this stage of the project successfully. If you have to spend long time, and I mean 2 full-time days or 2 part-time weeks on Define phase, that means that your scope is probably vague and too broad. In this case, you should talk to your manager or sponsor to narrow down your scope. Maybe you need to divide project in 2 or 3 parts, or adjust team to get resources and knowledge to get the task done. Way to speed up the Define phase is creating mini Kaizen events where people come for a half or full days of work to complete all work required. Of course, keeping the place without interruptions, emails, or phone calls. Making a project that is ignoring customer is always a bad thing. Therefore, do a thorough job of capturing customer needs. Create a well-balanced team from all different parts of the company and different specialties. For example, finance, IT, marketing, engineering. In this video, we covered first of the DMAIC phases. I hope you enjoyed it and that it brought you value. So hit the subscribe and like buttons not to miss future content, and I'll see you in the next one.